So let's talk about the storybook in this video, and also let's configure the storybook with our React web app. In this video series, we are going to introduce to storybook, and also we are going to use it, but not all the time. This video series will help you that how you can configure the storybook and how you can use it on your React app. But we are not going to go on a deep. So many times you will find that I'm not going to use the storybook for all the component. Okay, just a introductory session or a series for you for the storybook, because in a startup many people are using the storybook and it's really awesome. Okay, so let me give you a brief idea about the storybook. Storybook is a UI development tool, and with help of the storybook we can visualize the component in a isolation. What does that mean? So in the last video we discussed about the component, right? That all the web app, we just divide the thing in a smaller thing. That is a component. Like this is a one component, this is a another component. Also we can create this thing as a another component. So we discussed about the component in the last video, and now at the time of development we wanted to visualize this component. Like suppose we started working on this portfolio app, and at the first I wanted to see the circle avatar thing. Like I wanted to visualize this part only, okay? Or I wanted to make this card first, this card layout first. It is also a component, right? This is also a component. So I started working on this component first, okay? But how you will going to visualize it? Okay, in a React app, suppose you started working on it, then you need to make this page first, then you will go on this page, right? One by one. But I just wanted to visualize this component in a isolation. Okay, so now the storybook will come into the picture, that instead of working on the whole web, what we will going to do, we will going to work on a smaller component, and to visualize this component we will going to use the storybook. Okay, suppose this is another component, this is also another component, this whole card is another component. So instead of working on the directly on a home page, what we are trying to do, that we wanted to work on a smaller component, and we wanted to visualize it. We can't put that thing in our React website. Okay, also suppose we just wanted to focus on the UI first. Okay, we don't wanted to focus on the API integration or database integration. That time also storybook will help you, because storybook is purely for the UI thing, and with help of that we can visualize our component without making a API call or any kind of database integration. Okay, we can just visualize our component in a different way, like that will not affect our React app. You will not get this thing until I will show you with the example, but I just wanted to clear it out, that with help of storybook we can visualize or work with the component in isolation. So we can start working on this component without writing the code of the home page. Okay, so here we have some kind of example. So this is example created by the storybook only, okay, which is deployed on a Netlify. Okay, we are going to use the Netlify for our case also. After developing this portfolio web app, we are going to deploy it on a Netlify. I will going to cover that part as well on this video series, so please watch this series till the last. Okay, so this is the example of the storybook. So suppose here you will see we have a different kind of button, and we can treat this different kind of button as a component. Okay, similarly storybook also have a different kind of button. If you go here, then you will find this is another kind of button, this is another kind of button. So storybook, what will help you, that it will not, you don't need to write the code of the entire home page. You can start writing the code for this button only. So here if you go on an example, then you will find that we have a different kind of button, that is a secondary button. We have the outline secondary button, and that's the storybook use right here. Okay, so we can start working on the button itself without writing the whole code for the home page. And to visualize it, we use the storybook. So how we will use it, you will get the idea once we start integrating the storybook with our app, and we will going to start it soon. But this is a general idea. Okay, we wanted to visualize the individual component. Okay, and the storybook will going to help us. So we don't need to bother about the whole web app. We just wanted to bother about the individual component, like this button or this circle avatar or this card or this image also. Okay, so all these things we can visualize it on our storybook. Okay, so you will get all the idea once we will start integrating it with our portfolio web app with the example. But let's first configure the storybook with our web app. Okay, so we will going to configure the storybook with our portfolio web app. So what you have to do, that we already created our project with the Chakra UI and the TypeScript. So we just have to use this npx sb init. Okay, suppose you don't have a sb install, first it will going to ask you to install the npx, ask you to install this sb globally, and after you will install the sb globally, then the code will run. Okay, so I already have installed it. So if I will go here in our project, so this command you have to use on your root directory of your project. So my root directory is the portfolio, so you have to use the npx sb init. Remember, if you don't have sb installed globally, then first this command will help you to install it globally, this sb package, then this command will run. So let's use this npx sb init. It will going to ask a couple of question to configure it. So if I will use the npx sb init, then the process will going to start, and it will going to take some time also. Detecting project type, it will first detect the project type, that what kind of project it is. Storybook, we can configure it with different kind of UI library like React, Vue, Angular, or normal web components, HTML. So all type of thing is here, you can have a look on it. But we are configuring the storybook with our React app. So it will detect the project type, and now it's installing the couple of dependency. Okay, so let's wait till it install the thing, then we will come back later. So all the dependency is installed, and let's go on a package.json file. Then you will find that, okay, so let's go over here. Then you will find couple of things is already installed, like motion, React motion, and style. Okay, and also a storybook dev dependency is added, because this storybook is not required at the production level. We just need this storybook at the time of development level only. So all the dev dependency is added over here, and you will find on a script that there is another script is added, that is storybook. It will help you to run the storybook in a different server. Remember, React project will run on a different server and storybook will run on a different server. So both are different thing. Okay, storybook will not going to affect our own project. Okay, it will run completely on isolation with the React app. Okay, so we don't need to bother about the storybook bugs. Okay, so here we also have a build storybook thing, but most out of time we are going to use this storybook only. Okay, so let's run the storybook also to visualize it. So to run this thing, we have to use the npm run and the script which we wanted to run. So let's run it, and till it will start, it will take some time. Okay, till it will start, let's see the project structure as of now. Here you will find that there is dot storybook folder is added on our project. Okay, here you will find that thing. And also there is one thing is added on a source folder, that is stories. What it will going to do, inside the stories only we are going to put all kind of component visualization thing. Here we have an example thing. okay. So let me go here, and you will find this is a home page of the storybook, and here you will find one button is added. So if you go on a React app, and if you go inside the stories folder, then you will find storybook is already added some component like button.tsx in a TypeScript format. You will find it's added the button props, it added the button which is using the normal JSX thing. So this is a button component, and to visualize this button component, we have a button.storage.tsx. So here you will find it kind of complex, but don't bother about it. We will simplify it on our videos when we will going to configure it. Okay, so here we are visualizing the button on a storage. So if you go on a storage, then you will find we have the button, and inside the button we have a type of button: primary, secondary, large, small. So all kind of button we have here, and all are defined over here: primary, secondary, large. So don't worry about it. I just wanted to give you an introduction of stories that, yeah, for individual component we can visualize it with help of the storybook. You can see that in our React app we don't have anything. Oh, it's broke the our React app. Let's fix it. So after configuring the storybook, I was facing some issue regarding the babel loader conflict. To resolve that issue, what you have to do, that you have to add this babel loader dependency on this dependency object. Also you have to add it on a dev dependency as well here, just after the storybook React. Then what you have to do, you have to just use the ra-rf node modules to delete the node modules from your folder, and after doing that you have to use the npm install to install the dependency again. So please follow this fourth thing: add it on the babel loader, add the babel loader inside the dependency, also add the babel loader inside the dev dependency, remove the node modules, and do the npm install. It will fix the issue and your React app will start again. That's it in this video, where we discuss about the storybook and how to configure the storybook, because we are going to need this thing, okay, in the next coming video. Because first we are going to start with the buttons, so we are going to start implementing our buttons, okay. So we will start this button or this button or this button from the next videos, and we will going to visualize it on a storybook, and then we will going to start with this text thing, and after creating the smaller component, we will going to put it on our React app. Okay, so we will going to make a smaller component. With help of that, we can make a whole apps. Like this is a smaller component, and these are the smaller component, because we are going to use it all the time again and again. So let's meet on next video. Please don't forget to subscribe the channel and share the videos to your friend. Also like the videos to motivate me. Happy coding. See you on the next video.